I would certainly rate the students who come into BITS as quite smart. And they learn a lot of things on the fly. So it's not very difficult for us to actually teach them. It's actually a pleasure to teach them, I would say. There's a tremendous potential which I find in BITS students. Sometimes it's not fully utilized. So it's a challenge for us to actually bring out the best in the students in terms of providing them intellectual challenges.
CG matters a lot to me because at the end of my 4 years, I'm in my fourth year. So at the end of 3 years, I have realized that CG is the one thing that's holding me back when it comes to college applications.
One of the main things I keep in mind when I prepare for a class is that it should flow as a story very nicely for the students. Otherwise, if I'm just going to read out slides or teach in the sense that of just one time or one-sided speaking, then it might not go very well. The receptivity will decrease. So when I prepare for a class, it actually takes a lot of time because I have to think through what I'm going to speak and what is the connection between the slides when I use slides.
I think the flexibilities have been a very strong part of the BITS curriculum. I have not seen this happen in any other college. A lot of people I talk to back home, they're like, all right, all our courses are structured, this is what we do. And then I tell them, yeah, I can choose whatever I want to do.
Hi guys, this is Ravi here. I'm a part of Inspired Car Racing team of BITS Pilani. We have made this car. It's a formula style car. And the most important thing is that this car is fully built in BITS workshop. And it took us around 1 year to make it. We're a bunch of 20 people, 20 dedicated people who work day and night to make the car. It goes 0 to 19 just under 6 seconds.
The labs over here were brilliant in the sense that I could walk in anytime I wanted. There were huge machines in my first year. I hardly had any idea of what they were, and yet I could fiddle around with them without the faculty, you know, peering over my shoulder and trying to figure out what I was doing. Centrifuges, incubators, and all of these things are things which are actually used by proper PhD students and MEIs, and yet we were able to use the same facilities with the same amount of ease.
These labs are one of the source of great innovative ideas for us. Like very recently, we are coming up with a project which involves building a bot which can actually recognize the human emotions. So we're using the IP cameras and mechanic sensors.
For once, you can choose your own timetable. You can select your own electives. Also, you can have different disciplinary, interdisciplinary courses, and you can choose whether or not to attend classes. Of course, I think BITS has the most flexible academic system, and it is this flexibility, I think, which is helping me figure out what I really want to be.
This is Akyut. This is the first first indigenously developed humanoid robot at BITS Pilani. This project has been going on for 3 years now. This is the fourth version of the robot. It has won India's only and first gold medal at Robo Games. That is the Robo Olympics, basically. It was formerly called Robo Olympics.